And speaking of Joe the Plumber, let's go right now to Holland, Ohio. There he is himself at a news conference. Let's listen in.
You know, I'm not Matt Damon. I'm not any of those guys who, you know, have, you know, droves of women and men that want to be them or so on and so forth. And be like, yeah, oh God, I'll vote for him because Matt Damon said, I love his movies, but, you know, I don't have that kind of problem. You know, read it yourself.
What is it about you, do you think, that is so attractive to the two presidential candidates that they would mention your name four times more than they would even mention Iraq?
Yeah, I know. That bothered me. Be honest with you, I'm sure Obama didn't want my name mentioned, so it wasn't so much as that, but I'm sure he expected it. Like I said, it was just a focal point, and if it was helped the debate, then I'm happy for that. But I wish they would have, you know, I don't know, probably talked about more important issues. I mean, you know, support you on that one.
And when you registered with the Natural Law Party, what were you thinking then?
We've been there, brother, and come on now.
Well, it's a registered political party.
I'm telling you, I don't really remember, and yet you're going on. I mean, really.
That's fine. So you don't remember registering?
I told you that, right?
You said that you didn't know what they represented or something. I mean.
Okay, well. What? None of this is nationalism.
What is the biggest issue for you?
I have lots of issues, personally, and then so far as with the country. Biggest issue? I don't know if there's a biggest issue.
Your son, for example. Yes, what do you hope for your son's future?
Not to have to pay $10 trillion back. I mean, come on now. I mean, you know, Social Security is a joke. I like to, you know, I have parents. I don't need another set of parents called the government. You know, let me take my money and invest it how I please. Social Security, I've never believed in, don't like it. I hate that it's forced on me. You know, as far as for my son, you know, I want him to live in America that he's proud of. I'm tired of people downing America, saying that we're this bad country. I mean, that upsets me and my friends greatly. You know, we are the greatest country in the world. Stop apologizing for it. I mean, really, it just, I get real mad about that. I'm not sorry for being American. I'm not sorry for, you know, having the things I have. I've worked for them. I'm not sorry that, you know, I wish that our borders were closed and that you have to come through in a legal manner. I'm not sorry for any of those things. I'm not sorry that we're in Iraq. I mean, you know, my friends in the military that have come back and told me the thanks that they've received for us being there, it doesn't get enough play. I mean, we've liberated another country. I mean, you know, freedom. Things that every one of you guys take for credit, take for granted. Everything that Americans take for granted. I mean, these guys haven't had it. Now they got it? I mean, that's an incredible thing. I mean, it's almost, you know, I don't know if you guys are Christians or not, but it's like somebody coming to Jesus and becoming saved. These guys have freedom. You know, our guys here that are poverty-stricken, they have cell phones. Those old people over there, you know, they have one pair of pants and a shirt. You know, so what we've done over there is an incredible, incredible thing. Has it kept us safe? Absolutely. I believe in that 100%. WMDs or not, I don't care. You know, we took the fight to them. We've done a pretty good job there. Could have done better? Yeah, sure. But, you know, it's easy to be an armchair quarterback. You know, in hindsight, they say it's 20/20. I call it x-ray vision. You know, so, you know, I'm, like I said, proud of our military and, you know, proud of what we've done over there. So that's pretty much the main thing there.